Sun Midong, Ambassador of People's Republic of China, Mr. Khalid Rahman, Executive President, Institute of Policy Studies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to be here at the Institute of Policy Study for this special session focusing on Pakistan-China relations in the perspective of CPEC and beyond. I appreciate the efforts of the Institute in arranging seminars and discussions issues, especially in the context of all-important Pakistan-China relations. Our two countries share common interests and aspirations. As such, our strategic partnership is a factor for global peace, stability, and progress. Pakistan accords special importance to collaboration with China, especially in recent years. Trade and economic relationship has become the centerpiece of our bilateral relations. Pakistan is greatly indebted to China for its cooperation and assistance that fueled progress and growth in many important areas, including energy, infrastructure, manufacturing, electronics, computer hardware, software, transport and construction equipment, and mining. Pakistan government is keen to share with our Chinese friends the advantages occurring from our strategic position at the crossroad of Central Asia, South Asia, West Asia, and China. We envision a peaceful, prosperous, and integrated Asia, just like China, as per its One Belt, One Road vision. The China-Pakistan Economic Corridor is a torchbearer of this shared vision and common objectives. Allow me to say that CPEC is not just a trade route between two countries, its significance goes far and beyond. More than anything, it's a pivot of regional connectivity and mutual and shared development. Aiming economic regionalization in the globalized world, CPEC envisages combining the growth engines of South Asia, China, and Central Asia into a massive powerhouse, driving socio-economic uplift of 3 billion people of the region. As for Pakistan, the fruits of CPEC have already started bearing some of the cherished dividends with reduced electricity charges and improved connectivity between underdeveloped and developed areas. It has also opened up the possibility of funneling investment into resource-strapped energy and infrastructure sectors, as well as underdeveloped areas. This will help accrue twin-pronged benefits such as sustained growth and improved socio-economic uplift for all based on equity and equality. I take this opportunity to emphasize that Pakistan-China cooperation is vital to the protection and promotion of international peace and security in a multipolar system confronted with serious challenges such as terrorism, regional conflicts, energy crisis, and environmental degradation. So let us join hands, combine synergies, and forge wide-ranging, stronger, and sustainable partnership by harnessing the full energy of our masses and turn shared ideas of peace and development. There was a mention of some changes in the political atmosphere, and it had raised initially some eyebrows also in Pakistan. But let me assure you that the Pakistan-China friendship, especially CPEC and other projects, they are now owned by the entire nation. They are not particularly confined to one political party or one region or one province. It is now the ownership of the entire nation, including the armed forces of Pakistan. I conclude on sentiments of affection and goodwill to the people of China, praying for their continued progress and prosperity.